I really hate to say it, but we are doomed, people.
Thanks a lot for coming along with Life with BillSiff. Let's see what's really going on.
How you doing today? Welcome to Life with BillSiff. I'm your host, BillSiff. Well, I got my media player, Kenwood, piece of shit in today. Just in the middle of mounting this plate, and you can't even like have a tight fit with it because this is what kind of metal you get now when you order a mounting plate for a radio. You get one hell of a good grade of metal. Do you remember when you used to get these things and you couldn't even bend them? Hardly. Now, they bend if you look at them funny. So that thing's a piece of shit. So we're just gonna skip right by that for now, and I'm gonna find a better one that I just gave away. Hey, Bri? I'll find a better one down the road and we'll put it in because that one's junk. So this is a pretty easy install. For anybody that's running an amplifier in their car, you know, well, you might not know, but you're gonna know that you don't need all them, because those are all speaker wires that we're not gonna need because we're not running off the deck power. So we're gonna be running off the old amplifier. So we can just take them wires right now and just give them a little bend over like so and tape them up so we know we're not using them. There we go, Captain. So basically all we're gonna need here is we're gonna need ground. We're gonna need constant power for memory, which is yellow. We're gonna need ignition power, which is the reader doesn't stay on after you turn the key off. And we're gonna need a remote line for the old stereo, which is this one. That says Pecont antenna. What the hell? Hold on, they changed it. Mute antenna. So we use a Pecont antenna instead of, you know, I don't know why they wouldn't put remote line, but they don't. This one here basically goes to your amplifier to turn it on, which is this wire right here in my situation. So we can take that off and we can undo that and we can twist it right onto there. Now, just so you know, this stereo install is gonna be a quick one, so I'm not gonna do any soldering. I'm gonna do what they call I will not let go twist knot, which will be just fine. I know some of you are gonna say, Bill, it's not like you not to solder. It's not like there's a lot of power going through this or anything, so you don't really need to solder a damn thing. Ow, careful. So we're just gonna tape it up like so. Excellent, oh yeah, why wouldn't you? So that's a good one there. Now we need ground, which is that one right there. So we'll use that ground. Now I'm not gonna cut this one because we haven't got much ground here. I can't reach in there, so we better keep her out here where I can get to her because my fingers are big. And if I do it the other way, we're not gonna be able to get to it. So we'll strip that and we'll hit the ground. My suggestion to you when you're hooking up a head unit is to always put in the ground first or the remote, doesn't matter. The remote's not gonna get any power until you get power anyway. So before you put constant power and all that stuff, get your ground on there. That way everybody's happy. I still can't believe that cage. That just blows me away how cheap that was made. So next we're gonna do is a memory. This is constant power. So we'll get it hooked up. And this will keep, you know, your radio stations and stuff all set there. When you shut off everything and turn it back on, you won't have to reprogram everything and get all cocked over. People overcomplicate this stuff. It's actually pretty simple to hook up a stereo, it is. There's not much to it, if you know what I'm saying. So this one here, we also have a dimming feature, which this head unit don't have because, you know, it's a piece of shit. So we don't need the dimming feature. We don't need the mute feature. And that's about it. So we can do away with that one. So all we need now is this key power, which is this guy right here. My poor carpet's getting all covered in cut wires. Why wouldn't it be? Oh well, we can clean that up. So if you get your hand through a steering wheel like this, you can normally get a pretty good go at twisting on her. You can, as you see. So there, that's all there is to that. That's basically all you need to know about hooking up a radio in an old school f***ing Chevy picker repa trucker. Not too much to do. So now that that's done, find the antennae, which is right here. My hand's stuck, Jim. Okay, we're gonna have to hook that up from underneath because it's not long enough. Basically, all we're gonna need to do now is run a mic because this thing has Bluetooth. I forgot about that. Where's my mic? There should be a mic here. Here it is. Where should we put the mic? I'm thinking up here somewhere. Where I'm thinking. How you doing? You're supposed to put it over here somewhere so you're not near the door window. I don't know about that too much. I'm thinking maybe down here somewhere, maybe even for now. Let's just figure that out right now. So if I take this, like so, and I stick it up here, will it stick up here? Let's see if I can get it in up here. Can I get it in the middle? Can I get it on the side? Can I get it in here? Oh, dick, there it is. No, not really. That's kind of in the way. How about just putting it right on the visor? Can we do that?
Maybe. Oh, it's plastic too. So you can't even squeeze it.
Oh, there we go, that's a good spot. So we'll put it right there on the visor and we'll just kind of throw the wire around for now. We'll wire that off camera because you don't need to see that. Basically, when you're done that, you just put the wire where you want it. Okay, you understand? Perfect. So it'll go down here and around here and into here, and then we'll kind of just run over to here and into here like this and bring her up behind, stick her through. and then we can just plug it in. There we go. See, that's how that works. So now you just plug in the audio cables, which is front and rear. Let me see here. Front. Ooh, it's got a subwoofer. We got a subwoofer action. So there. I'm not sure how I did these wires, but there and there. We're gonna have to check on the amp there. Green is red. If that makes any sense to anybody at all. So now we'll stick this into here, and that's it. Then we can shove that in the hole without a friggin' lock and faceplate. So if anybody wants a stereo, I got one, and it's upside down. We might want to turn this around too. It's kind of not facing the right way right now. Let's give it a little swing over and around. There we go, that looks better. Always looks better when you put them in up right side up, eh? Decent. That's all there is to mounting that, temporarily. So now all we gotta do is go up front and hook up the power wire for the amplifier, and we should be able to try this thing. Let's do that right now. So as you can see here, we have a wire. So what we're gonna do with this wire is we're gonna cut it somewhere. I'm thinking right about here somewhere. We're gonna throw this little doodad in here. Now what this little doodad does is it stops you from burning, because no one really wants to burn stuff down, if you know what I'm saying. So I'm gonna start by doing that on one end, and we'll keep that. And then I'm gonna do this on the other end, and we'll keep that. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this thing apart right here, and we're gonna take this thing apart here like so. Some of these have a flow way, but I don't think this one really matters which way it goes, disconnect. So you can put this any way you want. Now it comes with a little red waterproof doodad, so if you wanna pull that out of there, you can slide that onto your friggin', oh, you wanna slide this on first. Sorry about that, almost fucked up there, Jim. Then you wanna slide this on here, like so. And this is almost designed for this piece of wire, as you see. And then we wanna get a Allen key that fits this. So we'll turn that screw a little bit, stick that in the hole, and give her a little snug job. Yeah, that's not the right size Allen key. Let me just bring over my adjustos. That way I don't have to keep walking back and forth on you and cocking the video right over, because I can't find an Allen key that fits. Hopefully this one fits. There it is. And then we'll screw that on. There we go. And then we'll take this other end, we'll do the same thing. Pop that out, slide that over, turn this out, slide this in, tighten it. Now, as you can see, I got pretty big wire here. This is, you know, high quality stereo that we're putting in here. So we wanna make sure we get a big enough wire to run a hamster. So now that we're running this huge piece of wire here, like this really big wire, we can get away with one of these to go into my awesome battery terminal, because I got side post. If you don't have side post, you don't know what I'm talking about. You're missing out. Side post is the only way to whatever. Side post is awesome. So we'll shove that in there like that, and we'll give that a squeeze. Real good one too. Give it a pull, make sure you got it. See, I didn't have it, so that's why you pull on it. Here we go, let's try that again. Give her a little twisty, stick her in, make sure she's in there nice and deep, and give her another squeeze. This time we'll give her a little bit more than last time, because it didn't work too good last time, as you've seen there. And then we'll give her another pull. Oh, there we go, that's better. Now we're gonna take the battery off and turn the fuse off.
Okay, we're good.
When you're hooking up, always make sure your fuse is off to the amplifier until you get her hooked up, Jim. Just because, you know, that's the way you should do things. So we'll get this out of there, and we're gonna turn this out. There it goes. Now we'll take this wire, and we'll go into here. We'll put this back through. Of course it don't. Why would it? I swear they make these things too small for this kind of shit on fucking purpose, just to frustrate the cocks out of you. Leave your comments down below if you agree with me. I'll guarantee it they do though. Or they do it because, you know, they don't really want using it for what we're using it for. I still think it's the other way around. Just cock us over. Captain. When you're doing this, always make sure you use something like this to hold it, because that's why. See, look at it. Just doesn't want to do anything. It's just gonna wreck it. Because everything is built so fucking perfect anymore that it doesn't even have the strength to fucking hold itself up. Another thing you can do is just take your cutters and cut the goddamn thing like that and spread it apart, because, you know, nothing's built to worth a shit anymore. I'm gonna start saying, I'm gonna show you how to do something that's not worth a shit. How to lose your shit. Maybe I'm just not spending enough money. Is that what it is, boys? Girls, peoples? Leave your comments down below and let me know if that's what it is, because if that's what it is, then I'm never gonna have anything good anymore. Where'd my doodad go? Get up here, you son of a cocksucker. So now, see, we can like kind of wedge that through like that and stick it back in here and pretend that we didn't see any of that cobble fucked up fucking shit we just did. There's gonna be a lot of editing for swear words in this video. Holy cow. Sorry about that. Apologize. But it is what it is. Sometimes you have to swear to get somewhere. All right, so now that that's done, we can put this back on here. Maybe, maybe not. Come on, you f***ing whore bag and piece of shit. No good for nothing. Sucker. Oh yeah, this is just an absolute gem in the making. I don't know what to tell everybody besides it's quite the world we live in right now. It is. So there we go. Oh, stripped. We're doing good. Now we need a new battery terminal. This is f***ing ridiculous. Like, even the f***ing battery's a piece of sh**. I hardly even f***ing turned on that. I'm gonna lose it, man. This is bullshit. 100% bullshit. It's just gonna be on there and hand tight for now. There we go. We need a new one of them now, too. So, why the f*** wouldn't we? So, turn this f***ing thing on, and hopefully the f***ing thing blows up. Actually, before we fire this up, I'm gonna take a look at the settings on the amp, because I didn't use this last. And it's probably all dicked over. So, what we got is absolutely nothing. Where the hell's all the f***ing gain controls in this piece of s***? Not there, obviously. Am I missing something? Maybe they're behind the faceplate, are they? Well, no, they're not there either. Oh, come on, there's gotta be controls. Maybe not. Maybe it's just, no. I've never seen an amp that don't have any controls. Come on. Is it in here? No. In here? No. In here? No. In here? No. In here? No, I'll be dipped. I'll have to look it up. Let's just try it then. Never seen an amplifier with no gain controls before. That's new to me. Oh, we got power. Oh, look at the way that fits in there. Isn't that great? Holy. Press the knob for language. English. I'll take English, please. How do you get to English? English, French, English. Well, what the f*** one is English? They all say English. I'm gonna go with English. No, I don't want Spanish. Aw, dick. Yes, to whatever I just did. Standby. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to connect my phone. So we'll go source. I haven't hooked up the antenna yet. Remind me to hook up the antenna. We'll go Bluetooth device. So now we'll pull up the old phone-a-rooski here and see if we can't connect. There it is. Pair that bitch. You're right, dude. Pairing. Okay. There we go. Paired. Allow it. Wouldn't you? You're not gonna believe it. It actually worked.
Good for you, I guess you moved on really easily. You found a new girl and it only took...
Oh my god. No device, it says. What have I done? Oh my god, haven't I? Getting bright is the soup. Okay, f*** you. So there is adjustments on that amp somewhere. The 6x9s are on subwoofer. Well, I just finished hooking up the stereo. It works, but the craziest thing is this Clarion I got back here that I got given to me. It's a clone. There's no gain controls. There's no subwoofer controls. There's no high-low pass switches. I open it up, and it's not even a Clarion. It's got a little tiny amplifier in it. It's about that big, and the shell is about, you know, you see the size of the shell. It's bigger than my hand. Whoever you got this from, Shorty, she's a clone. She is. She's a knockoff piece of garbage. That's freaking awesome. But anyways, at least we got the stereo hooked up, so, you know, it works. Doesn't work great. It sounds like deck power because, of course, that thing's a piece of crap. But other than that, we got her working. So we'll maybe upgrade that in a bit. Not really worried about it right now. It has tunes, so that's all that matters. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe and like and hit the notification. Thanks for watching. Welcome any new subscribers. And until the next one,
you know what to do for now.
And this light is freaking distracting the hell out of me.